I'd like to now turn it over to Mr. Capuccio.
Just what members of the...
Oh, the offices.
Do you have any other questions?
Aye.
Aye.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States. The Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
State of New Jersey.
And bear true faith and allegiance.
And bear true faith and allegiance.
To the government established.
To the government established.
In the United States.
The United States.
This place.
State.
Authority of the people.
Under the authority of the people.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Aye.
Aye.
That I possess qualifications.
That I possess qualifications.
Prescribed by law.
Prescribed by law.
Office of...
Office of...
Member of Board of Education.
Member of Board of Education.
I am not disqualified.
I am not disqualified.
As a voter pursuant to...
As a voter pursuant to...
Revised Statute 19-4.
Revised Statute 19-4.
Nor disqualified due to conviction.
Nor disqualified due to conviction.
Of a crime or offense.
Of a crime or offense.
This is New Jersey Statute 18-8.
This is New Jersey Statute 18-8.
That I will faithfully...
That I will faithfully...
Impartially...
Justly...
Justly perform.
All the duties of that office.
All the duties of that office.
Best of my ability.
With the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Took so many hours.
Okay, I will take roll call now. Mrs. Avery?
Here.
Mrs. Rivera?
Here.
Mr. Days?
Here.
Mrs. Evanson?
Here.
Mr. Grant?
Here.
Mr. Ham?
Here.
Mr. Hubbard?
Here.
Mr. Ramico?
Here.
Mr. Norm? In accordance with Public Law 231, notice of this meeting was provided to the press, the Current, and GTV, and posted in the municipal building on January 10, 2015. The report of the annual school elections is attached. I would like to acknowledge the receipt of the certified results from the County Board of Elections of the school board election held on November 5, 2015. All in favor? Any opposed? Thank you. I would now like to open the nominations for the President of the Board of Education. Do I have a nominee?
Do I nominate Karen Hubbard?
I'm now closing the nominations. I'd now like a motion to approve the appointment of Ernie Hubbard as the President of the Board of Education. Mrs. Avery?
Yes.
Mrs. Cordero?
Yes.
Mrs. Evanson?
Yes.
Mr. Days?
Yes.
Mr. Grant?
Yes.
Mr. Ham?
Yes.
Mr. Hubbard?
Yes.
Mr. Ramico? I would now like to turn it over to the newly elected President to conduct the election of Vice President.
She's my name. Pick me up.
Your name is...
You got it, Ernie?
That's it. Yeah, it's a term of the show.
I you everyone for your confidence. I promise you I won't let you down this year. Okay. Can I have my hat?
Yes, sir.
I feel better now. Thank you. At this time, I'd like to open nominations for the Vice President of Board of Education, please. Thank you. There are no other nominations. I'd like to close nominations, please. Thank you. Can I have a roll call vote to appoint Suzette Rivera as Vice President of this Galloway County Board of Education?
Mrs. Abraham?
Yes.
Mrs. Cordero?
Yes.
Mr. Davies?
Yes.
Mrs. Effingson?
Yes.
Mr. Brad?
Yes.
Mr. Hand?
Yes.
Mr. Hubbard?
Yes.
Mr. Ryan?
Yes.
Motion carries. Congratulations, Suzette. Okay, meetings. Attached to your package this evening is attachment A2 for the meetings of 2016. They've changed since the last one I proposed. Has everyone had a chance to look at them? We'll open up for discussion. If there's anyone has a discussion about the times, not the times, actually just the dates. Please.
The only question I have is the month of June. Closing out on the school year, they have 2 weeks, and the same in August, that's the opening meeting for school year. We can approve faculty and staff and everything that changes the school year.
Actually, President Hubbard and I did discuss June, and the difficulty and the challenge we're concerned about the second Monday in June is right now we are scheduled to close on June 10th. And so the second Monday would be right around that last week of school. So with school closing, it's actually better from the administrative standpoint to just plan for one board meeting. Obviously, the calendar is at the discretion of the board, but we feel comfortable doing all our preparation and just doing one meeting in June. In terms of August, we used to have two in August, but have moved to the model to do one in July and one in August, and that spreads the business out. If the board would prefer to in August, then I would propose that we not do the July. But we are comfortable business-wise with the way they are.
One of the things, Rich, that we did, we split up August. We used to take July off. The reason being is that to get personnel here with the 60 days notice. We can, obviously, if we need that to in August.
Still keep the order in July.
Right. We can always have 2 hours if we need to.
I have a question. Does the Board Institute count as a meeting?
Yep.
Yes.
So we're having 3 in Denver right now?
Yes. Any other questions about the schedule? Can I have a motion to approve the notice of meetings as presented? Any other discussion? Any public comment? Can I have a roll call as presented?
Mr. Davies?
Yes.
Mrs. Abraham?
Yes.
Mrs. Cordero?
Yes.
Mrs. Evanson?
Yes.
Mr. Brad?
Yes.
Mr. Hand?
Yes.
Mr. Hubbard?
Yes.
Mr. Annika?
Yes.
Okay, the next, we'll take real quickly. Item number 11. The appointment of the safety coordinator is recommended by the School Alliance Insurance Fund to appoint Chandra Naya as the safety coordinator for the 2015-16 school year. A motion to follow Robert's rules of parliamentary procedures, fees that are set by the board policy, adoption of bylaws and policies that are bylaws and policies set by the Board of Education, dated September 1978, subsequent amendments and revisions are the sole policies in existence to direct the operation of the school system. Item 15, the adoption of the assets, obligations, and contractual agreements of this Board of Education required by law. Item 16 is the ratification of all existing agreements and contracts previously negotiated by previous Boards of Education are in accordance with the provisions and stated herein. Item 17, I'll read, I know this takes a little bit of time. Adoption of the, and discussion of the Code of Ethics is adopted by the Jersey School Boards Association as follows. I will uphold and enforce all laws, school board rules and regulations, courts, orders pertaining to schools. Desired changes should be brought only through legal and ethical procedures. Item 2, that I will make all decisions in terms of the educational welfare of the children and strive for public schools which can be met, meet the individual needs of all children regardless of their ability, race, sex, creed, or social standing. Number 3, I will confine all my board action to policy making, planning, and appraisal, and I will help frame policies and plans only after the board has consulted those who will be affected by them. Number 4, I will carry out my responsibilities not to administer the school, but together with my fellow board members to see that they are well run. I will recognize that authority rests with the Board of Education, and I will make no personal promises nor take any private action which will compromise the board. Item number 6, I refuse to surrender my independent judgment to special interests or partisan political groups or to use the schools for personal gain or for the gain of friends. Item 7, I will hold confidential all matters pertaining to the schools which, if disclosed, would needlessly injure individuals or the schools. But in all other matters, I will provide accurate information in concert with my fellow board members, interpret to the staff the aspirations of the community for its schools. Item 8, I will vote to appoint the best qualified personnel available after consideration of the recommendation of the chief school officer, administrative officer. I will support and protect school personnel in proper performance of their duties. Item 10, I will refer all complaints to the chief administrative officer and will act on such complaints at public meetings only after failure of an administrative solution. We have to add to the agenda, yes. Can I have a motion to approve the items as read?
Second.
Any board discussion? Any public comment? Can I have a roll call, please?
Mr. Anderson?
Yes.
Mrs. Evanson?
Yes.
Mrs. Ebring?
Yes.
Mrs. Cordero?
Yes.
Mr. Davies?
Yes.
Mr. Brett?
Yes.
Mr. Hamm?
Yes.
Mr. Hunger?
Yes. Thank you. Committee appointments. I'd like to make committee appointments for the Board of Education Committee for 2016. I just happened to notice that the one presented in the packet is blank. So, with that being said, yes, it is. We'll start off with facilities. At this time, I'll ask Mr. Dianico to chair the committee along to serve with him Mr. Days and Mr. Hamm. On the Finance Committee, Mr. Knorr will serve as chair, Mr. Days and Mrs. Cordero will serve with Mr. Knorr. The Township Liaison Committee, which was formerly known as Government, will be chaired by Mr. Days, and Mr. Brett and Mrs. Avery will serve with Mr. Days. Negotiations Committee, I'm asking Mrs. Cordero to chair with Mr. Ianico and myself will serve with her. On the Policy Committee, Mrs. Everson, I'm asking for you to chair, and Mr. Hand and Mr. Days to serve with you. Technology Committee, I'm asking Mr. Brett to chair, and for Mr. Hand and myself to serve with you. Technology. On the Township Planning Board, the non-voting seat, Mr. Days, I'm asking you to represent the Board of Education. On the Zoning Board, non-voting seat, Mr. Greb, I'm asking you to represent the Board of Education. I will represent the Board of Education on the Superintendent's Advisory Committee. Hold on to this there, Dr. Quinto. I know, I want to be more active on it for you. The Education Foundation, Mr. Knorr will represent the Board of Education. And then the Jersey School Boards and County Association, Mr. Rivera will be our delegate, and Mrs. Avery will be the alternate. Yeah, since he's going to be.
Okay.
Yeah, we have the three. Okay, and there's an item I need to go back to my briefcase. We need to add to the agenda. Oh, yeah. Okay. appoint Phoenix Advisors for the Continuing Disclosure Agent Services from January to June 2016. Can I have a motion to add them to the agenda?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The ayes have it. Okay. Have a motion to appoint Phoenix Advisors for Continuing Service Agent Services from January to June 2016, please.
So moved.
Can I get a second?
Second.
Thank you. Can you explain what Phoenix Advisor Services does? Does it not happen?
They actually assist with our continuing disclosure through the audit. They look at our debt service and our big picture and our financial advisors and give us disclosure statement to our audit team to put into the audit in our continuing
disclosure. Okay.
And also, they also look at, well, if we do have an option for refunding bonds or anything along those lines, they are the ones who give us that advice to financial advisors.
For just the debt?
Yes.
Please.
So we work with several financial advisors throughout the year, and with Phoenix, the way our interaction with Phoenix is we do interact with them in this capacity. So what we prepare is the disclosure report, which is probably a 40-50-page report after the audit is completed. We work with Phoenix to visit them, and they upload it to a site called EMMA. It's electronic market. Municipal market access system, which is required, has to be done within accordance to your bond. When you guys have a bond sale, this is for certain requirements. So it might say 180 days of the end of your fiscal year. So those documents have to be filed with up on EMMA with the existing bonds we have outstanding. In addition to that, what they do, which we do not do for you, is they also look for something called material events. And that is, I think there's 17 criteria that may qualify as a material event. One of those is bond downgrades, which has happened recently, and that once a year or the next couple of years that's occurred. And you have within 10 business days or 10 days to file up on that of any downgrade or anything that qualifies as a material event. So they can handle those material event filings when we get to it.
Since we'll be paying off majority of our debt,
we still have one outstanding in 2024.
And we're still going to need the services, even though that's a small amount?
Correct. Because you have to comply whatever that document continues to
be. The bill, whatever the note says.
Exactly. Because someone from the district signs off on that new issue bond.
Okay.
It's $850 for the year.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes.
Any other board discussion? Can I have a roll call vote, please?
Mrs. Cordero?
Yes.
Mr. Hand?
Yes.
Mrs. Avery?
Yes.
Mr. Hayes? Mr. Prince?
Yes.
Mrs. Evanson?
Yes.
Mr. Grant?
Yes.
Mr. Hunter?
Yes.
Mr. Ranico?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Is there any public comment at this time on the reorganization meeting? If none, then we might as well just go into the regular meeting. And since you were standing, I guess you might as well stand up again. Introduce yourself formally, please, and tell us what you're doing.
Dandy from Bowman Company. Board hires a new audit for this past year. We completed the audit, actually, and everything was filed in December. This is kind of an unusual time for us to actually come to present. It's nice to be here at the organization anyway. Congratulations to the new board members, even though they're not new to the group. So you should have received your CAFR, Comprehensive Annual Financial Report, as well as this Auditor's Management Report. Hopefully you can see that on time to plan that. I'm just going to go over a few items with it and kind of explain to you why the timing is different this year than in past years. And also there's a few new sections of the road that haven't been there in the past. We completed the regular audit, we've also funded the student enrollment counts and district transportation counts. We had three state single audits and three federal single audits as well. That's based on expenditures, they received $500,000 in the grant area. We've also completed the data collection form, that's been filed, uploaded, and certified by the district administrator. As well as the audit summary worksheet, and that's an upload through the Jersey Department of Education. So everything's been completed at this point. The reason for the delay in timing is normally we're here and we should fit everything in September, file in October. Things changed this past year with a new accounting standard, GASB 68, and that really has to do with pension reporting. So this is the first year we've had to actually report liability on your district-wide statements related to pension. In the past, it was just put in a disclosure, and there's an actual actuarial calculation that's done by the state of New Jersey, and that was delayed. So this is the first time the state had to provide this information, and it's the first year that the district has to incorporate it in their audit. So this calculation was done, and that was delayed and wasn't released until I believe sometime in November, and that was the state extended their audit deadline through December 21st, and that's why we're here today. So just a few items to talk about in the audit. The MD&A, Management Discussion and Analysis, that's on page, I'll just mention some page numbers if you want to note them and then you can always go back to them later. But that is the only area of the audit where you're going to see a two-year comparison in the numbers, and it kind of adds an analytical aspect to some of the figures. It also gives some explanations on significant changes from the prior years to the current year. The A statements, it starts on page 26. That's your really your net position. It's called district-wide or government-wide. That encompasses the entire district as a whole into one. In the district-wide, there's the new GASB 68 standard, county standard, has been pushed through. And you know, you're going to compare last year, this year, especially looking at MD&A, you're going to see a significant change in the numbers, significant decrease. And it's not like the liability wasn't there in the past, it just wasn't full. So it's nothing that the district has done, but it's just a new standard which makes the numbers look much different than they have in the past. On page 37 starts the notes of the financial statements. For some of the newer board members, if they wanted to understand maybe the accounting treatment of how the seats handled or what certain items you might actually need, note one is a typical book that kind of gives you a detailed explanation of what each item is. Also in the notes, you'll find information on some of the new GASBs. You'll also find a capital reserve detail, which is on page 49. Sometimes that's helpful when you're trying to we're looking at the future projects. Also, there's a debt service payment schedule by year, you can find on page 52. You'll see that if that changes over the next couple of years, and that's a significant item to be, know about for planning purposes. On page 53 starts your pension footnote. That used to be one page, now it's eight. There's a lot of information there. Important items, I guess, related to that. And also, you'll find this in your house statements, which we'll quickly mention in a second. But for your pension liability, the PDRS and the TPAF are done differently. So the PDRS, Public Employee Retirement System, that's the actual liability that's both on the records now, and that's approximately $17 million. The TPAF liability, because that's paid by the state of New Jersey, you want to get payments annually. You actually never make the payments. The district doesn't make those payments. The state makes them on your behalf. That liability, which is $127 million, that is not booked. So these are pretty big numbers that you're not just seeing in your audit report. And that all came from the actuarial report of the state. And you'll find information on that in the footnotes, as well as the outhouse statements, which are a new group of statements that are in your audit report. Those can be found on page 86. So you could look at both of those at the same time when you look at it. Page 65 gives you an explanation of the fund balances and what it's made up of and what it means. I just to clarify a little bit on fund balances, in the footnotes, that's not on a GAAP basis, which is as above, but these statements, this statement is you budget for the fund balance on a budgetary basis, which will be on the last page of your C1, which will have it. The difference between the two is the last two statement payments will be deferred from the current fiscal year to the following fiscal year for the state purposes. So the last two statement payments are $2,236,000, so that would be the difference between the two funds. There is a restatement at the beginning of that. There's a lot of new things this year, I'm sorry. But usually there's nothing to talk about. So page 67 is your restatement. We actually, because the way everything was required to be done on our end, we had to restate the beginning balance to take into account the new pension liability. So we restated the beginning balance, which the current year activity through, and then we did not redo the prior year's information. We just restated the beginning balance. That's a $16 million adjustment, and that's all. Page 70 starts your, which is called your C1. That's your really your general fund budget, your revenues, and then your policy and appropriations. And that's really where 9% of your expenditures and revenues are made out of. The last page of that, which is on page 81, will give you the fund balance detail. And this is the detail that you're going to need when it comes time to work on your budget for this coming year. Page 86 is your house statement for the next thing in the audit, and we'll see some of the details of your liability amounts. Page 99 is your capital projects, that's where they start. And then page 100 and 107 is your enterprise fund income statement. That will be your food service, tuition, community education operations for the year. So if you wanted to see how those four programs last section of the main capper that I wanted to mention is the base statements. We start on page 120. There are the statistical statements. This area is a 10-year recap of certain information. There's some financial information in the front, and then there's that information for 10 minutes. Operating statistics, tax levy. You know, if you wanted to get an idea of where things have gone, or you know, where they came from in 10 years, you can find information on that, student enrollments, all that information will be there. The single audit section is the last section in the audit report. We do not have any transfer findings, and we do not have any audit findings. And PAMR, there's some information on student enrollment accounts, as well as meal accounts, and detail of how the excess surplus calculation is prepared. That's pretty much everything. I know this is exciting for you guys. There's some new stuff, and if there's any questions that the answer, I'd be happy to.
I know there's, so if I remember correctly from the financials, there's money to carry over to be plugged for this year's fund balance to be plugged for taxpayer relief in 2016-17, correct?
Yes. Your amount that you're required to put in is tax relief at a minimum. You usually put in more for tax relief, but the minimum amount that you're required to put in would be $2,200,000
for tax relief in 2016.
Yes. Okay. That's on page 81. Yeah, that's something that the last page of C1, there's a big capitulation in the bottom, and it kind of breaks out the different balances, how much is capital reserve, how much is fund balance. Your emergency reserve and maintenance reserve.
All right.
document, the first time I heard it, so on my desk, here, I just saw it in my mind. But on page 140, exhibit, Jason, I don't know if this question for you, Dan, or for Dr. Giacquino, when they talked about full-time equivalent staff, the administrative numbers from 2011 to 2015, or 23, did we not increase in administrators in 2014?
Well, Mr. Chairman, if you remember, in the year that we did all the cuts, we reduced two positions, and then we brought one position back.
So, I mean, it's indicating the same number in 2011 as it is in 14 and 15.
I will have to look at it.
Okay.
It could also be a classification issue, so maybe it's something to look into.
I just thought that you guys might respond by a principal.
We had a principal from those school, that is correct.
Right, so well, since the numbers are reflecting from 2011 to 2015, the same amount of administrative has issues with that.
I will certainly look at it. President Hubbard had a question to me about those numbers as well. And one of the things that is noted that they are pulled from the personnel database and reported to the auditor and then get pulled into the audit. So sometimes the issue is how things are coded or classified and what's called position control. So we certainly can.
All right, thank you. And, one other thing to note is that those the J statements are unaudited statements, so they're pulled from various places. And most specifically said at the top of the statements. And the bottom and the legend will say where the information came from. So we don't test check that information. What we do go up and make sure it's, you know, someone assisting with the audit.
Any other questions from the board members? Any other questions on financials? Okay. Andy, thank you very much.
Thank you.
See you next year.
Thank you.
If you like, Andy, you'll have to stay for home. You have a long drive home, I understand. Drive by, you have a name. Superintendent's report, please.
Thank you, President Hubbard. Happy New Year and good evening to everyone. Although not listed on the agenda, Mr. Cuccio did send a report to us today. So I'll turn it over to you and you to share with you.
Sure. As information, I don't really much there. Except the fact that we did receive an offer of judgment. We mentioned last time it's coming to that, the case that they had against the Arch Concept case. We'll be fully remunerated. We've got all expenses, all costs. We should have no charges and costs whatsoever. That's in the process of settling that matter now. The subcontractor, supercontractor, and had us on the case, if you recall. Nothing else to speak of at this point.
Okay.
Thank you. Great news. No. Any questions from our solicitor at this time? Thank you.
Thank you. We do have one item for action, a resolution to accept, modify, or reject the harassment, intimidation, and bullying report presented to the board on December 21st, 2015, to the reporting period of November 19th, 2015, through December
16th, 2015. Thank you. Can I have a motion to accept these harassment, intimidation, and bullying report that was presented to this board on the 21st of 2015, December 21st, 2015, for the reporting period November 19th, 2015, to December 16th, 2015, please.
Second.
Thank you. Any board discussion? Any public comment? May I have a roll call, please?
Mr. Pease?
Yes.
Mrs. Avery?
Yes.
Mrs. Cordero?
Yes.
Mrs. Evanson?
Yes.
Mr. Crabb?
Yes.
Mr. Hale?
Stay.
Mr. Hubbard?
Yes.
Mr. Ayanko?
Thank you. Curriculum instruction, please.
Yes, we have one item this evening, a resolution to approve the Arthur Rand MD class to participate in the New Jersey Special Olympics at Stockton University in Galloway on January 8, 2016. The transportation costs are covered by the FSA.
Thank you. Can I have a motion to approve item number one under curriculum instruction, please? Thank you. Any board discussion? Any public comment? Can I have a roll call, please?
Mr. Ryan,
yes.
Mrs.
to operations, please.
Yes, I'll turn the agenda over to Mrs. Denali.
We have a resolution to accept the audit report for the year ending June 30, 2015, as presented by BOE Company, and acknowledge receipt and review of BOE Company's peer review report issued by Pfizer and Ember, LLP, no audit recommendations.
Thank you. Can I have a motion to accept item number one under finances to operations, please?
So moved.
Second.
Any board discussion? Any public comment? I do like to mention that, actually, John Norris called me today. I just wanted to mention that when he met, and the finance team met, 2 months ago, was it? Or last month, okay? Last month, I'm sorry, you're right. With Bowman and Company, there were no comments at all with the auditors, which is highly unusual for those who are in the, who are not in public accounting. For an organization this size that has all these moving parts and all these bills to pay and then all these regulations to follow, for them to come in and not find a mistake.
For how many years?
Yes, for a material mistake. That for how many years? It's quite a time. 4 or 5. Because Vicki didn't have any. Timothy E. Kelly didn't have any. This is heck.
This was the problem. This was all the back to back in the summer.
It was a group effort. But I got to tell you, though, I get a lot of it myself. And it is quite an outcome not to have any comments at all. So the business office team and everybody works very hard to make sure that there is no comments and corrective action. So it is quite an accomplishment. So John is very proud of the business office team and the whole administrative team that work so hard to get us this every year. So it's quite a feat, at least from my eyes, because I am in the field. It is very hard to do. So again, you just want to make sure that you publicly announce this, that it is a nice job that you do. And thank you for reminding me, because you did call me today, as a matter of fact. From Florida, remind me how long it was in here. So. Okay, any other comments? Can I have a roll call, please?
Mr. Kraft?
Yes.
Mrs. Avery?
Yes.
Mrs. Cordero?
Yes.
Mr. Pace?
Yes.
Mrs. Evanson?
Yes.
Mr. Hand?
Yes.
Mr. Hubbard?
Yes.
Mr. Ayanna?
Yes.
Thank you, and I will show that to the business office president.
Thank you.
We have a resolution to approve the contract between Fort Worth Public School District and Galloway Township for tuition to be placed in our BD classroom at Reedsburg Elementary School. The total tuition from January to June is $20,621. A resolution to approve the contract between Camden County Educational Services and Galloway Township Board of Education for OT services at $68 an hour for the 15-16 school year. A resolution to approve the contract with mobile lease modular space to replace the modular building at the middle preschool. The contract price is $124,553 for delivery and installation for a monthly lease payment of $1,500 for 24 months. This is in accordance with the Keystone Purchasing Network.
Thank you. Can I have a motion to approve items 2, 3, and 4 under finance and school operations, please? You can't do anything until we. You can ask for a discussion. Until I get a motion, and the first and the second, technically we can talk about it. Can a motion to discuss?
So moved. Second.
Thank you. Sir, now you may have a question.
Sorry about that. On item number 3, is that a student that's out of district?
No, that's actually students that are here. We have reached capacity, and then some we are going to be using a contracted service to come in at legals. Twice a week, I can get the total
information for you. Any other questions?
I just want to clarify for a module that's covered under grant.
That was part of the preschool
station, correct?
Richard, please.
Yes.
these, these, these. And let me know, because then I will just contact the mayor myself.
I still have that copy of the state.
Okay.
He said we shall not pay, we should not pay the fees.
Thank you. Yes, we don't like paying fees to the township, but we don't have to.
Well, it goes from right pockets to left pockets.
Right. Or left, correct. Any other public comment? Can I have a roll call, please?
Mr. Ryanico?
Yes.
Mr. Days?
Yes.
Mrs. Avery?
Yeah.
Mrs. Cordero?
Yes.
Mrs. Edmondson?
Yes.
Mr. Rudd?
Yes.
Mr. Hand?
Yes.
Mr. Hubbard?
Yes. Facilities maintenance?
We have no items this evening.
Community use school facilities?
We have no items this evening.
Personnel?
We do have a few. Resolution one is to accept a letter of resignation from Leslie Gray, Library Secretary, Arthur Brand Elementary School, effective January 15, 2016.
Thank you. Can I have a motion to accept item number one on personnel, please? Thank you. Any board discussion? Any public comment? Can I have a roll call, please?
Mr. Ryanico?
Yes.
Mrs. Edmondson?
Yes.
Mrs. Avery?
Yes.
Mrs. Cordero?
Yes.
Mr. Days?
Yes.
Mr. Grant?
Yes.
Mr. Hand?
Yes.
Mr. Hubbard?
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you. Item two is a resolution to approve the following job descriptions. This is a second reading, accounts payable, confidential secretary to the school business administrator, board secretary, payroll specialist, and transportation coordinator.
Thank you. Can I have a motion to approve item number two on the personnel, please?
So moved.
Thank you. Any board discussion? Any public comment? Can I have a roll call, please?
Mr. Days?
Yes.
Mr. Ryanico?
Yes.
Mrs. Avery?
Yes.
Mrs. Cordero?
Yes.
Mrs. Edmondson?
Yes.
Mr. Grant?
Yes.
Mr. Hand?
Yes.
Mr. Hubbard?
Yes.
Thank you.
Policy?
We have no policies this evening.
Okay. Notice public meetings. 7 p.m. On the 22nd. I thought we were starting sooner than that.
President, that is the official time. I mean,
where meeting starts at 7?
I believe so.
What time is dinner start?
5.
5. Everybody's going to be there at 5 o'clock. Tom, I know I had talked to you about this. You'll be there at 5?
I'm going tomorrow.
I'll be here at 2.
You come.
I'll be here at 2.
Bev?
Bev, you will be there.
Hey, do you think Bev?
Please, you'll be there by 1. You'll be here at 8 o'clock in the morning.
Okay. Tom, are you coming by yourself?
Yes.
Okay. Beverly, you're coming. Bob? Who's bringing you?
Here, Mr. Davis.
Okay. Madeline?
I'm running myself.
Okay.
Rob, would you ride with somebody?
Michael, are you going to be there by 5 o'clock?
I'll be there by 5.
Okay. Are you coming with the...
I don't know.
Okay.
If I'm available, I'll be there too.
His spouse is available.
Yeah.
We Carol Schwartz needs to know final reservations to make sure she has that correct. Mm-hmm. She gave tentative based on what she had in the center.
Okay. And can we be there by 5 o'clock?
If I can get out of work on time, I'll be there by 5 o'clock. As well, this is denied.
All right. We'll make sure we start dinner at 5 so we don't need to come forward.
7. Yes, that is what his work
is. And Jane?
I believe so.
Okay. Yes. Yep. Board self-evaluation will do
next
Friday after you're done. You are excused. All right. The meeting. Eagle Pie. Anything else? We have a closed session tonight.
We do not.
No. All right. I hate to disappoint you. All right. Let's go around the board. Tom, you're off the hook tonight since you're the newbie.
No, I'm just looking forward to being here.
Oh. Dan, you want to go first and go ahead? Beverly?
I just want to say happy New Year to everybody and welcome to our new member.
Bob?
Same as what this person says. And I'm glad to see Roy is here.
Correct. Abbott? Richard?
Nothing tonight.
I got a return suit back.
You got a return suit for the win.
Yeah.
And congratulations, Kelly, on a...
Smiles? Okay. Board of evaluation, happy new year, see everybody that Friday night. Is there any public comment to come before this Board of Education this evening before I adjourn?
No, Eagles.
Okay. If not, good night. Up to that motion adjourned. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? The ayes have it. Good night.
Hi, good night.